calculate the position of the shear center for the given channel section, the thin walled channel section. And thickness T is constant, okay. So the flange width dimensions are same, B and B, top and bottom. And thickness T is constant, and the overall depth of channel is H section. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the corner points. Okay. And this is the axis, this is the x axis, which means that IXY is zero product of inner shear. And for this, we need only SY. As you all know, that the shear center point will lie along the axis of symmetry. So S axis is zero. So if you just recall the equation, the very big expression for the shear flow, you substitute IXY is equal to zero and SX is equal to zero. This is the reduced form of expression which is applicable for the given section. Okay. So already I have explained this IXX, how to calculate for the thin wall section, in the topic approximations of thin wall sections. Okay, so this was the IXX for the section, th cube by 12 into 1 plus 6b by h. Okay. The neglecting the IM powers of t, and this is the IXX, th cube by 12 into 1 plus 6b by h, 1 plus 6b by h for the given thin walled channel section. Now let us calculate the shear flow values. With the help of the shear flow values, we'll try to look at the shear center in this case. Okay, in this case, now let us take a section or 1 to 2, the points 1 to 2. Okay, small element ds at a distance s from the TN. You can start either from point 1 or point 4, your wish, as I told you already. So this is our expression, okay, to s. Okay. And y value for the small element is minus h by 2 below x axis. Okay, minus h by 2 below x axis. So substitute this y value with the shear flow expression, minus s y by ixx integral ty ds. Okay, ty ds, y is minus h by 2. After integration, this is the expression. At 1, s is 0. So q1 is 0. At 2, s is equal to b. Okay, at 2, s is equal to b. You get the shear flow values. And the shear flow is positive. Okay. So the direction of the shear flow will be as the same direction of S. Okay, you can see here. Okay. And also if you look at the term, here it looks like S power is 1. So it's a linear equation, like y is equal to fx plus c, straight line, linear variation. The linear variation, you can see here the shear flow is 0. At Q2, you have got some value. You can draw a straight line. Hence, it forms like a triangle. Okay. Now, 1 to 2 is over. Now, 2 to C. Okay, 2 to C. Okay. Now, we have tried on the shear flow expression. I told you the previous shear flow value will be carried forward. Okay. So this Q2 will be carried forward here. This value and minus S by X 0. The S T Y D S is the shear flow formula, and at small element at a distance S from 2, we need this distance H by 2 minus S, and below X axis, so minus of H by 2 minus S. Substitute here, integrate it. At 2, S is equal to 0, this is the shear flow, which is same as the previous shear flow values, which means that our expression is correct. Okay, and at C, S is equal to H by 2. Sorry, here it is given as 2, but at C, here it should be C by mistake. Okay, at C, S is equal to H by 2. Okay, so QC is equal to, substitute here in this expression, you will get the shear flow at the centroid point, at centroidal axis point. Okay. Always remember, whenever if any section is symmetric about, for example, if a section is symmetric about X axis, if it is subjected to SY alone, always the shear flow will be maximum along the axis of symmetry, as we have done for shear stress in beams, that is, along the axis of symmetry or at the neutral axis of the beams, shear stress is maximum. Just like the same way here also, along the axis of symmetry, shear flow is maximum. Okay. And two, we have got the same value as we got for section 1 to 2 here, you can see here. At 2, same value, Q2. At C, you have got the value. Okay, this is the value at C. Okay, at C. Since the given section is symmetric about x-axis, subjected to SY alone, the same whatever value you have obtained here, that you can have a kind of a reflected image to the top triangle also. The same triangle, same Q2 value we get. And again, QC is positive, so it takes the same direction of S. So you want to do, it follows the S direction shear flow, same direction, and again it has to be like this. When you try to calculate the shear flow between 3, 4, starting from 4, you'll get minus shear flow value, which means that the direction of the shear flow will be in a direction opposite to the S direction. Now, if you calculate the area of this triangle, see, always remember, I told you already, area of the shear flow diagram gives you the shear force. This area and this area both are equal and opposite. Both will get cancelled each other. Now, if you try to calculate the area of this, which is nothing but area of the rectangle and area of this parabola, will be equal to the shear force Sy, which is nothing but externally applied load. That means our expressions are correct, shear flow values are correct, shear flow distribution diagrams are correct. Now let us assume that Sy is acting at a distance E from the vertical web, from the web to the. You can show this Sy right side of the web to 3 or to the left side of the web to 3, your wish. In this case, I have taken to the right hand side. Okay. So if you take a, if you write down the moment equation with respect to 2, Sy into E anticlockwise negative. Okay, I'm taking moment with respect to 2. Why I should take moment with respect to 2? Why not 3? Why not 4? Why not 1? Why not C? You can take whichever point you want. Okay, it's your wish. The reason for choosing this particular point means the moment produced due to this shear flow and due to this shear flow, it will nullify the moment. It will not give any moment because distance is 0 as it coincides with the point 2. If you take moment with respect to this, the moment cost due to the shear flow will be 0, whereas these two will contribute to the moment equation. So if you take with respect to this, these two are nullified. The only term, which is contributing to the moment is this term, this shear force. So off into base into height, off into b into. So this is off, and Q2 is nothing but. So if you take a moment, with respect to 2, for example. So I told you area of the shear flow diagram gives the shear force. So off into B into Q3. Q3, Q2 both are same. Okay, don't bother about that. So off into B into Q2 is the shear force multiplied by the perpendicular distance h. Okay, multiplied by the perpendicular distance h. Force into perpendicular distance. Okay. We are taking this SYE to the other side. SY will get cancelled. Substitute IXX, which we have calculated already. And E is nothing but 3B squared divided by H into 1 plus 6B by H. So this is the shear center location formula for a thin walled open section. So here in the shear center location, we are not getting any SY term or SX term. Load is not at all playing a role. The shear center depends on the geometry of the section. Here SY gets cancelled, right? The shear center location term or the formula shows only the dimensions of the thin wall sections. It is not showing any SY at all. Okay, it is not showing any SY at all. So this is the shear center location E value. Suppose if you get this E to be negative, that means the position where I have assumed that SY is acting, that should have been shifted to the left hand side. Here, this position is correct, something like that. So whenever you assume any location to act either SY or SX, if the resulting shear center value is negative, means you have to change the location. Okay. Thank you.